I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do snake skin with gel polish. Yeah, so we're going to do a snake skin effect on this nail. I've already created a ballerina style nail. And what we're going to do is we're going to use this gorgeous purple to start with. And then we will use this pink. And I know what you're thinking. Snakes aren't pink and purple. However, we want to make it less creepy because Callie, our model today, is slightly afraid of snakes. So she feels like every time she looks down, if it was like, say, green or like a brownie colour, she would look at her finger and be like, oh my God, there's a snake there. So we're going to make it a pretty snake. So we're going to start with the purple. Because we're doing this on top of an acrylic nail, we do not need to use a base coat. If you are using a natural nail, then you would need to put the Urban Graffiti gel polish base coat on. And that would keep it on. We don't need it now though. So I'm going to do two coats of that. So I'm going to use a dampen dish. I'm using the bottom. So I need to use this with a brush. And we're going to start to map out the scales of the skin. So you're not going to have a snake anytime soon then. It's easier to start at the top than it is at the bottom, I find, anyway. And once you've got one set in, it's a lot easier to do the rest. So now from that, we can do a line down off that corner, a line down off this corner. And then we're going to do a line here. So you can always do a little dot so you've got somewhere to meet. So you bring that line and meet that dot. You go, hello, dot. And the same here. And then you're going to do your bottom line. These do not need to be completely symmetrical. Don't worry if it goes a little bit off because scales are not perfect. Just like me.
I thought they were.
They're not all perfect.
Really?
No, they've all got inconsistencies in them. Very slight inconsistencies. I think it's like a fingerprint.
Everyone's different. So, yeah. I mean, it's nature, isn't it? Nothing's uniform in nature.
Mm-hmm. So you can see by doing that first one, it just lines up the next ones that you're going to do. So you're going to repeat this pattern all the way down. So again, I'm going to do two little dots. And you can even go from the dot to the edge of the nail, or you can go from the edge to the dot, whichever way you prefer. So repeat this down the nail. I'm going to go over with the matte coat now. We're going to matte this out. Make sure you cover all of the nail and also cap it as well. If you don't cap it, you run the risk of something chipping at the edge. Pop me that in. I I'm going to use the gel residue wipe off solution and take off the sticky layers. As you can see, it's nice and matte now. I'm going to get Mega Gloss, pop it in my little upside down dampen dish. What I'm going to do now is take this, I'm using the dotting tool, you can use a brush or a dotting tool. I was trying to think of something else you could use, but yeah, I'd use a dotting tool or a brush. And then you might want to cure, well, we will cure these in between, so we'll flash cure them. So you want to tickle it into that shape. Flash me that. So if you were doing a full set, you could be doing the other one at this time. You can just have them keep swapping. Concentrate on the big scales at first. I think I'm going to do another one quick. Did it pop me down in? It bled onto the...
Were you painting across the lines?
Yeah, it went on the lines. And this old paint by numbers thing was not working. It bled. It's because it does kind of feel like it's paint by numbers. So I needed less product. So because you'd flash curing them, if you do make a mistake like I did just, you can just take that off before you cure it, obviously, because the rest of the scales are cured already or on their way to being fully cured. Pop that in. I'm using Mega Gloss because it's a little bit thicker than the Urban Graffiti top coat. You could use it with that as well, that'd be fine, but I just wanted it to be a bit more raised. And then the little sections at the side, all they're going to be is a dot. Pop that in. And you're just going to do that all down both sides. Really simple. You do not have to tickle them out into those diamond shapes. Do not worry about that. I've fully cured that now. So you can see that we have a matte background. And we have shiny scales because... a snake looks wet, don't they? People think that snakes are slimy because they're shiny, but they're not. Sorry, I'm a creeping you out. Sorry. Have you never been on holiday, Callan? Had like a snake round your neck. Even my Elise has done that with a great big, like a white one.
Oh, look at that.
Big, massive white. You're right. I think that's quite a easy way to create snake skin nails without using for real snake skin. Because that would definitely creep Kelly out, wouldn't it?
I'm never speaking to you again.
You have to, you're my family.
I don't.
You do. You need to.
We're not that close.
There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't done so already. All the products we've used today are in the description box below. Don't forget to check us out on social media like Facebook and Instagram and all that shebang. And I'll see you in the next video, guys. Bye!